I am always looking for new ways to record and edit podcasts, and I had someone recommend Soundtrap to me. So I thought I would give this a shot today. All right, just gonna log in, and what can I do here? Start 1 month free trial. I'm just gonna skip that, and let's go into the studio, I guess. Okay, so in the studio, I can choose to make a new project. This is all in the web browser, by the way, so that's pretty cool. I'm going to choose podcast, and it looks like you can even record this with other folks, maybe. Keep it in dark mode, and yeah, let's see if I can record a track. So, let's say add new track, voice and mic. I'm going to say allow the microphone to be used. How can I tell what microphone it's using here? It's weird, I can't. Oh, here we go. So I'm going to choose my SSL2 as the input, and let's start recording. Justin Jackson here, and I want to welcome you to my... All right, so let's hit stop there. You can do auto-tune. That's kind of funny. I don't think we want auto-tune for podcasts. All right, so let's see if we can play that back. Hey everybody, Justin Jackson here, and I want to welcome you to my tech review podcast. All right, well, that's pretty cool. Let's see if we can now add, there's a loop library. Let's see if we can use some of these. All right, I kind of like this one. Let's put this one as my intro and let that play for a bit. Hey everybody, Justin Jackson here, and I want to welcome you to my tech review podcast. That's pretty good. It looks like I can change the volume here on the backing track. Hey everybody, Justin Jackson here, and I want to welcome you to my tech review podcast. That's pretty cool. And of course, if I wanted to use this again as the outro track, I can do that there. And let's see if I can export this now as an MP3 file. It's taking a long time to finish that MP3 export. And it looks like I can also transcribe my voice track and edit the track visually. Okay, so if I want to delete this part, maybe I can do that somehow. How do I do that? I've transcribed it. How do I edit this now? Here's the transcription. Play from here, text correction, paste audio. Yeah, I wasn't able to get this editing the transcript feature. Well, this is funny, they got different ways to, I can add, what's this, a little darker? What does this do? I can modulate my voice.
Hey everybody, Justin Jackson here, and I want to welcome you to my tech review podcast.
That's pretty fun. Let's see what else they got here. Voice transform. So I can voice transform my voice to very dark. Let's see what this does.
Hey everybody, Justin Jackson here, and I want to welcome you to my tech.
I can make it brighter.
Hey everybody, Justin Jackson here, and I want to welcome you to my tech review podcast. I'm reviewing...
Okay, this is interesting. I clicked export audio. I've got like a 40-second audio file here. It took like 3 or 4 minutes for it to actually prompt me to download the file. So it took a long time for it to prepare that file. Let's just click OK here. And let's open this up in QuickTime and just listen to it locally here.
Hey everybody, Justin Jackson here, and I want to welcome you to my tech review podcast. I'm reviewing all sorts of software for podcasters, by podcasters, and this is my first time using Soundtrap so far. It seems really great. I'm going to have a full review.
All right, so now I've played around with it for a few minutes, a few quick thoughts. Number one, this is a pretty nice in-browser editing experience. It's nice that they've got all these loops here. It was fairly easy to record. I've got multi-track editing. All of that is pretty impressive. It did take a long time to export the file as an MP3 file. Really small 40, 45 second audio file. Took about 5 minutes to process before it prompted me to download the file. And that would have definitely been faster if I was editing locally using GarageBand or something else. The other thing I couldn't get to work was this transcription feature, which it transcribed my audio okay, but I couldn't figure out how to edit the audio using this interface. I'm not sure if that's in a different, you have to upgrade for that. Soundtrap is really geared towards musicians, and so every once in a while it would prompt me for, you know, a feature that's really more geared towards musicians. I think most folks would be fine on the free plan. So if you're looking for a fairly full-featured digital audio editing tool for podcasting in particular, this seems like a great choice, especially because it's available on the web. They also have a mobile app, so you can record podcasts on the go. Not everything worked perfectly, but overall it feels like a pretty solid choice. And I didn't have a chance to test this out, but there is the option to record remotely with a guest. So you just click here, copy the invite link, and you can then invite someone to record with you. This might be a good alternative to Riverside or Zencaster. If you're looking for everything to happen in one place, this looks pretty solid. So that's it for this quick review of Soundtrap editing software for podcasters. I'll keep playing around with it and maybe do a longer review later. In the meantime, I'd be curious to hear what you think, if this is something you would use. Maybe in the comments, mention what audio editing software you're using for podcasting right now. Thanks. See you next time.